Okay, so we have this convolution cyclopeptide sequencing algorithm, and it works really well on the hypothetical spectra that we've considered. But these spectra aren't necessarily representative of spectra that we might encounter in practice. So in particular, we had 25% false and missing masses. And that's much less noisy than what we will be able to obtain from practical spectra. Also, I've said that the mass spectrometer we can think of it as a scale, but it doesn't really just weigh the peptide fragments. It's a lot more complicated than that. What it does is, first it ionizes the peptide fragments, so it converts them into ions with a positive or negative charge, and then it sorts these fragments using an electromagnetic field. Once it does that, it's then able to not measure the mass, but the mass-charge ratio of each fragment. Then it determines the intensity, or approximately, we'll think about it as the number of ions at each mass-charge ratio value. And so after it determines this intensity at each mass-charge ratio value, we're able to create a graph from this. And so this is really what the spectrum is. The spectrum is a graph of the intensity on the y-axis and the mass-charge ratio on the x-axis. So it's detecting the number, give or take, the number of ions at each mass-charge ratio value. And from this, we somehow need to convert it into mass, right? All we have is mass-charge ratio. So these, we want to consider the most popular elements in this, or the most intense peaks is what is the term that we'll use. And the challenge is now to reconstruct, in this case, to first convert to mass, and then use those masses to reconstruct the peptide in a case where we may not have 25% false and missing masses. We may have like two-thirds of the masses that are detected in our spectrum may be false, in which case we've got to really switch up what we do, and we may need to adapt the algorithms that we have. And so on STEPIC, this is where we give you the example to take a real spectrum and try to process it and adapt the algorithms that you have, maybe come up with new ideas, and try to sequence a real peptide from a real experimental spectrum.